Today, I'll be using our Excel add-in PyBuilder to create, edit, and delete AF objects in bulk. So I have a pretty simple AF structure here. I've got a wind farm root element with three wind farms underneath it, but only one of my wind farms actually has any turbines in it. Now these turbines are based off of a template where all of the attributes will use a PyPoint reference based on the parent name, the element name, and then the attribute name. So why don't we use that template to populate my Drafty Delta and my Gusty Gulch wind farm sites? Here in Excel, we'll select the PyBuilder ribbon and then make sure we're connected to the correct asset server and database. And indeed we are. So I will import my elements. Clicking this Retrieve Elements button, I get to choose between importing all my elements, finding my elements based on a search string, or browsing for elements graphically. But since my element tree is pretty simple, I'll just import all my elements. Now at this point I get to choose which columns will be imported with my elements. I need to include these four required columns, but I'll also include the template because I need to specify I'll be creating turbines, as well as all child elements underneath my root element. So I'll hit OK. And here we can see that my wind farm element was imported, as well as the three children of my wind farm, and then the five turbines underneath Breezy Bluffs. So to create the Drafty Delta turbines, I'm going to copy and paste one of my Breezy Bluff turbine, and then simply fill out down to turbine 8. And I'll be using object type element and template type turbine. And instead of Breezy Bluffs, I will select the root path and hit Control H and replace anything that says Breezy Bluffs with Drafty Delta. So now when we publish these 8 turbines, they will be underneath this wind farm Drafty Delta parent. So it's a similar process for my Gusty Gulch turbines. I'll copy and paste one, fill out 4 turbines, their type element, and they're going to be template turbine. But instead of the Drafty Delta, I will hit Control H after selecting the root path for these 4 and change Breezy Bluffs to Gusty Gulch. Alright, the last thing to do is select the rows that I want to publish. So I'll copy and paste this X down to these 12 turbines that I just made, but I will remove the X's from these rows up here so I don't edit them at all. And we'll click Publish and edit mode Create Only after we've selected our 12 turbines and hit OK. Now let's go see our turbines in PySystem Explorer. So after refreshing and expanding these two elements, we can see that my turbines were successfully created. And we can see that their attribute names are correctly using the template. But as I scroll down to the end of the turbine list, I realize that turbine 8 doesn't actually exist. Drafty Delta only has 7 turbines on the site. So why don't we go back into Excel and delete that turbine. So I'll unselect all my turbines that I don't want to change and simply select turbine 8. Now at this point I want to delete the turbine, but we've grayed out this button as a default to make sure that you don't delete anything by accident. You can activate the delete button by clicking on settings and then allowing delete. So I'll do that now. And simply click delete, and yes. So it looks like it has succeeded. Let's go check by refreshing our element tree, and we can see that it's gone there. Now moving on with the inspection, I'm noticing that my PyPoint references for Gusty Gulch aren't actually working properly. And I'm realizing now that Gusty Gulch is a little bit different. This site doesn't use this same parent turbine attribute name PyPoint reference scheme. What it's actually going to be is gg.turbine4.currentOutput. So that's no problem. Instead of typing this in PySystem Explorer, we can use PyBuilder to make those changes all at once. So opening up a new sheet, I'm going to import my elements again, but this time I will browse for elements so I can select my Gusty Gulch root right here. Now this time I won't need template, but I will need some attributes, namely the data reference and the config string. So we'll select those two and hit OK. And I'm just going to use my Excel tools to prune down this list a bit so I only see the pie points that I'm going to change. So we'll just unselect everything and only select the pie point references. And now I have a list of my four turbines of Gusty Gulch and their four attributes. So in here we can select the attribute config string, hit Control H again to find replace. And like I said, anywhere where there's a Gusty Gulch, that's going to be replaced with GG. And any place there's going to be a space, it's going to be a period. So that's the correct attribute config string for my Gusty Gulch. Let's go back into the PyBuilder ribbon and publish. This time I won't use create mode, I'll use the edit mode because I'm editing these attributes. And there's my changes. Let's go see if they worked. Coming back to PySystem Explorer, I'll hit refresh. And we'll see that I've successfully changed all 16 of my attributes all at once using this new naming scheme. Now that I've changed the attribute config string, this attribute won't actually change if I change the template anymore. To reset it back to the default, we can right-click and reset to template. After I do that, all the changes to the template will be pushed to the attribute. If you do make a template change you want to push to all of your attributes, right-clicking and resetting to template, right-clicking and resetting to template, right-clicking and resetting to template, for each of your attributes, for each of your elements, might be quite a task. But we can do that in PyBuilder using our Reset to Template button. So I'll select all the rows on the document and Reset to Template. And publish using Edit. And at this point, I'll refresh to update the spreadsheet. And we can see here that if I sort by PyPoint again, my attribute config strings accurately reflect the template again.